tidings, and you're telling your neighbor, telling everybody around you that they need to give their lives to the Lord, I bring good news to you, good tidings to you, and the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ unto you. And it is that gospel, glad tidings and good news, that you bring to the people, that the Lord says, yes, you understand what you're doing, you are responsible, and because of your faithfulness and loyalty, all the blessings of this new life and of this new year and of the better future I'm going to bring upon your life. Look at verse 8, thy watchmen shall lift up their voice, with the voice together shall they sing, for they shall see eye to eye when the Lord shall bring again Zion. It says the unity will be there, speaking the same thing with the same mouth, the same mind, the same spirit, and the same zeal, contending earnestly for the faith once delivered unto the saints. All the ministers of God, all the preachers, all the pastors, all the coordinators, all the group coordinators, all the women coordinators, all the workers, everybody with a united force and united voice and moving on in the right direction. There's no division, there's no disunity, there's no false doctrine, there is no somebody pulling up and some pulling, nothing like that at all. It is in that unity, coming together. Together, everybody accomplishes more. Together, everybody accomplishes more. And this is what the Lord is saying. We don't forget the lessons of the past just because we're now in the new year. All that the Lord has taught us in the past year, we still carry on everything, that together, everybody accomplishes more. And it says, look at that verse 8 again, thy watchmen, thy preachers, and then it says, your intercessors, every one of us, it says, shall lift up the voice, one voice, where the voice together shall they sing. And then it says, for they shall see eye to eye when the Lord shall turn and bring again Zion. And look at the result of that. We're looking at verse 11. In verse 11, it says, depart ye. Depart ye. Go ye from thence, touch no unclean thing. Go ye out of the midst of her, be ye clean that bear the vessels of the Lord. It says, now as we come to know the Lord and this new year, better things are waiting us and the better future are waiting us. It's saying that we depart from iniquity. Depart ye, depart ye. Go ye out from thence and touch no unclean thing, ye that bear the vessels of the Lord. What does that mean? Touch no unclean thing. Anything that makes your mind unclean. Anything that makes your body unclean, anything that pollutes your spirit, anybody that anything that pollutes your heart. A man touching a wife that's not your, a woman that is not your wife, that brings uncleanness. Touch no unclean thing. A boy touching a girl in such a way as to, you know, want to instigate or inspire or bring an emotion that is of the flesh, that is not good. Touch no unclean thing. And it says, if we're looking for the better thing, if we're looking for the fulfillment of the blessings of the Lord this year, it says that better future is starting right now. And then we're going to preserve ourselves from everything that is unclean. Look at verse 15. So shall he sprinkle many nations, the kings shall shut their mouths at him. And then he says, for that which had not been told them shall they see, and that which had not been heard, which they had not hear, they will, which they have not heard, they will consider. It's saying that blessings that you never knew, blessings you never heard of, they'll come upon your life, and they'll come in Jesus' name. I said they will come in Jesus' name. Look at Daniel. Remember what I was saying? Progressive realization of better, better, higher, greater, richer things in our lives. We're looking at Daniel. Daniel chapter 1. Daniel chapter 1, I'm reading verse 8, and then I'm jump down to verse 20. Daniel chapter 1, verse 8, this is how these people, Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, how they had the better things in their lives, better things around them. Even though they were in Babylon, a place of sin, a place of iniquity, a place of idolatry and defilement, yet these people made up their minds that they were going to have the better things, and they had the better things. And the same way you are making up your mind, the same way you are saying, oh Lord, this year will be a year of better things. A year that begins and then I'm going to go forward to that better future. Here is how it will happen. We're told in Daniel chapter 1 verse 8, but Daniel purposed in his heart that he would not defile himself with the portion of the king's meat, nor with the wine which he drank. Therefore, he requested of the prince of the eunuchs that he might not defile himself. That is his responsibility. Look at Revelation now of the realization of the, what the Lord did, progressive realization of a better future. Look at verse 20. And in all matters of wisdom and understanding that the king inquired of them, he found them 10 times, tell me the word, better. 10 times better. 10 times better than all the magicians and astrologers that were in all his realm. That's what the Lord will do for us when we take our stand. And then with real conviction, we'll remain righteous in the Lord. Those better things will come for you in Jesus' name. Yeah. Hebrews chapter 10. Hebrews chapter 10. We're reading there from verse 34. Hebrews. We're looking at chapter 10. Hebrews chapter 10. We're looking at verse 34. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 34. It says, for ye had compassion on me in my bonds, and took joyfully the spoiling of your goods, knowing in yourselves that she have in heaven a better and an enduring substance. A better and an enduring substance. Then he tells us in verse 35, cast not away therefore your confidence, which hath great recompense of reward. It says that we are following through this year, and then this is January now, February will soon come, just around the corner here now, and then March and April, and then as we go through towards the end of the year, then you'll be able to look back. You say, I add my confidence in my trust in the Lord, and I was standing in the Lord, and because I was standing and then fulfilling the responsibility of a real child of God, the demand of God, the request of God, eventually, look at me today, things are better. And the Lord is saying, hold on to that confidence in the Lord, and cast not away your confidence, which hath great recompense of reward, for ye have need of patience, that after ye have done the will of God, ye might receive the promise. For yet a little while, and he that shall come will come. Yet a little while, that blessing will come. Yet a little while, that prosperity will come. Yet a little while, that better future is beginning already. And yet a little while, Jesus Christ, who has gone to heaven, and he says, I'm coming back again. If it were so, I would have told you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. The Lord says, he's coming again. For yet a little while, and he that shall come, and will not tarry. Now the just shall live, how? By faith. But if any man draw back, did you hear that? If any man draw back, anybody getting ready to draw back, they are preparing to draw back and saying, well, I'm too tired. I don't think I can move on again. I don't think I can make it this year. I will make it. I said, I will make it. You will make it in Jesus' name. You will not turn back. You will not go back. You will not look back from the Lord, because it says, if any man draw back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. But we are not of them who draw back unto perdition, but of them that believe to the saving of the soul. The Lord is telling us then, keep on moving forward, and the blessings of the Lord will enrich our lives and make things much better, as the days go by and the months come by in Jesus.
You have received the message from our pastor, Pastor W.F. Kumuyi, the General Superintendent of the Parallel Bible Church. It is my wish that as you listen, you accept the old word and you will let them sink into your hearts. And by the grace of the Lord, you will never regret it. It is my prayer that by next week, when our pastor shall come up again to present another message, you will be there, your family will be there, and your friends. And I believe as you are listening to the message every week, by the grace of the Lord, you will never be the same. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, O Lord, because of today's message. We thank you, O Lord, because of the one you let us listen to last week, and the one we are going to listen to the next week, by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. If you tarry, We shall listen together once again next week. And if not, every one of us will be there with you in the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord that answers prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.